When the iPhone XR came out, I made the switch from the iPhone XS Max, thinking the camera would be just as good for those who want to save some cash, but I was wrong. After spending a month with the iPhone XR's camera, here's why I switched back to the iPhone XS. The iPhone XR, iPhone XS, and iPhone XS Max are all 12 megapixel cameras with the same wide lens, but the iPhone XS and XS Max also get a telephoto lens for portrait mode and zoom photos. The iPhone XR gets the same A12 processor as the XS and XS Max, so photos from the wide angle lens are going to be basically identical. As you can see here, the quality on the XR is up to par with the XS Max, with exceptional detail and dynamic range. The XS only gets ahead when you switch to the telephoto lens and zoom in. At 2x zoom, there's already a noticeable difference in detail and quality. Because the XR lacks a telephoto lens, it can only zoom in 5x compared to 10x on the XS Max while getting similar levels of detail. This may not be a big deal for some people, but there are many use cases where getting some extra zoom can really help. While shooting video, the XR only gets 3x zoom compared to 6x on the XS. Now that's quite a bit more limiting than in photos, so having that telephoto lens is a big deal, especially since you can get some great looking telephoto portrait photos. The great thing about the XR is it's the only iPhone that can take portrait photos using the wide lens. But it's just not the same as the XS, even though you do get some depth control and portrait lighting features. Before I tell you about the biggest issue with the iPhone XR's camera, here's a quick message from our sponsor.
When your website or service go down, it's more than frustrating. Incidents like this are inevitable, and it all comes down to how fast your company can respond. Opsgenie gives teams the power to respond quickly by notifying the right people in various ways, like SMS, push notification, or even an automated voice call. And if they don't respond, notifications go up the chain of command to make sure the issue gets resolved ASAP. It also tracks all activity and provides useful insights to improve future incident response. Sign up for a free 5-member company account by going to opsgenie.com and your next incident won't stand a chance.
Now the biggest issue with the iPhone XR's camera is that you can't take portrait photos of objects like you can on the XS. Apple quietly mentioned this, but most consumers only found out when they got their hands on the iPhone XR and started taking photos. It only makes sense that if you could take a portrait photo of a person, objects should work as well. Other single lens phones like the Google Pixel 3 can take them, so why can't the XR? Here's a couple images of objects taken on both the XR and XS Max. Obviously, the portrait shots taken on the Max are better. But what if you don't care about taking portrait photos of objects? Well, portrait photos of people suffer as well when you're using a wider lens. In this example, you can see how the subject's face looks more natural and proportioned with each higher zoom lens. Not only that, but the background compression and depth of field increases, making for a more pleasing image. This is exactly what you get with the iPhone XS's telephoto lens. As you can see, the telephoto portrait looks more natural and the increased compression makes for less distracting objects in the background. We see the same difference when taking photos of vehicles. The wide lens warps the car's body lines, making it look a bit odd. You're much more likely to sell your car on Craigslist using the image on the right. All jokes aside, the differences are definitely there. Luckily, the XR also gets a depth control feature, so you can increase the blur to make the portrait photos look better, but it doesn't get as blurry as the iPhone XS's. Although the XS camera is better in so many ways, there's actually a scenario where the XR is superior. If you've seen any of our recent iPhone camera comparisons, you'll know that the telephoto lens performs worse in low light due to having a slower aperture, which lets in less natural light. Since dual camera iPhones can only take portrait photos using the telephoto lens, the iPhone XR has an advantage when taking portrait photos in low light, resulting in better looking images with less noise. Those little drawbacks with the iPhone XR's camera, among some other general limitations, caused me to switch back to the iPhone XS Max. Ultimately, the XR still has the best single lens camera alongside the Google Pixel 3, according to DxOMark, and for $750, I'd say it's a pretty good deal for what you get. Nevertheless, the camera on the iPhone XS is undoubtedly better, so if camera performance is very important to you, I'd recommend spending the extra cash.
If you enjoyed this video, like it and hit that subscribe button. Also, check out our price guide, which makes it extremely easy to find the best deals on Apple products updated daily. Be sure to follow us on social media and we'll see you in the next video.